Hi everybody, so this video is a little bit long, but I thought it would be a great idea to showcase Shenhe and Zhao, the two characters that are currently on the banner, and I want to showcase Shenhe because there's been a lot of misconceptions about her being someone who's really good, so we're going to use a freeze team, including Child. And we're going to have Chi-Chi as our healer, Ayaka as our burst support, or burst DPS, and then main DPS would just be Child, and Shenhe as our support on the second half. And then first half is just pretty common Zhao team. You just have a healer, a battery character, a shielder, and then Zhao as your main DPS. This is pretty common in all Zhao teams, and, you know, just giving you guys kind of like an idea of who to pull for before the banner ends, because some of you guys are still stuck on if you should pull for Shenhe, but I'll get right into it, I guess. So, Shenhe, I think, is really good for if you like Cryo characters. The current Abyss 412 is not really made for Abyss 412. Floors 9 to 11, you can do with almost anything you want, and it helps out Shenhe a lot if you have Ganyu or someone who can, I guess, freeze with Ganyu or Komi, stuff like that, or even Ayaka. Chongyun could work. I don't recommend you pulling Shenhe just for Chongyun, because there are so many other supports that, you know, doesn't limit you. So I think Shenhe is really good, but at the same time, I don't recommend you pulling for her because her team comps are limited. So if you're pulling for Shenhe, you're mainly asking to use Cryo. You're gonna ask to use a Cryo mono team. And the game that we play is Genshin Impact, not Mono Impact. So, for people that, you know, are thinking about pulling for Shenhe, again, if you like Shenhe and her aesthetics, what you enjoy is what matters in this game. It's not about the meta or any of that, anybody's opinion. If you enjoy Shenhe, go right on ahead. But for people that are struggling clearing Abyss or are new to the game and need some characters, I don't recommend Shenhe. If you're an endgame player and, you know, you're just saving promos and, you know, you want some a character to have fun with for your cryo team, then go on ahead. But for what she has currently, I have her running one of the best sets. I don't have a weapon, and I've done some math on the weapon for her, I think it's Calamity Killer or whatever it's called. It doesn't really help her in that sense. So for everything else, I think Shenhe is only used if you want to make a cryo team. So it's kind of like more often, so you don't have to use Mona or Venti in that case because of the cryo buff. But is it really worth it to, you know, potentially summon 45 pulls for a character like that? I don't recommend it, but again, if you like her, that tops up everybody's opinion that you watch. So if you like her, go ahead. Yeah, so that's about Shenhe. Let's talk about Zhao. And I have constellations on my Zhao, but we're taking Zhao at C0, and I've had C0 for like over a year now. C0 Zhao is really good. He's a high DPS carry, fairly easy to build because most of his artifacts, or at least half of his artifacts, come from doing bosses and weekly bosses, and just even regular bosses for his ascension material. If you guys don't know, his best set is the 2x18 set, which includes Gladiator's Finale, and the Veridescent set. The other set for if you don't want to do Gladiators is also really easy to farm because I'm sure you guys have known the set called Emblems of Fate. They're both in the same domain, so it's kind of like a 2-for-1 because Emblems of Fate can almost work for anyone. So the Shell is a really, you know, easy investment in terms of artifacts and pretty straightforward build. You know, he's gonna stay in the field and plunge up and down for basically the duration of the whole game. You probably put a shield on him, whether it's Diona, Zhongli, or even just having the team. So that helps him a lot, and for him to get through, you know, the content and still be viable, even after, I think, almost a year since his banner is released, he is a really good character. Again, I'll do a review if you guys want later on for Shenhe, but let's stick to Zhao right now. So Zhao, I recommend if you don't have a DPS and you'd like to, you know, clear some content in the Abyss if you're currently struggling, he's a very easy build. And his damage output is just insane. As you can see, the display that I'm showing with him right now. So the only thing about C0 Zhao is you have to give him a battery. Two animos sometimes doesn't really work out depending on the ER. So if you're around like 120 ER, I recommend giving him a battery, whether it's Diona or Bennett or anybody who can give a battery. I'm using Albedo for the battery now. And I have constellations, like I said, on my child, but for people that don't have constellations and you're using them at C1 at face value, I do recommend a battery just so he can have his bursts up in time. And another downside to Zhao a lot of people don't talk about is that he's not very he's not meant to be a single damage like main DPS. So where he excels is that if you have many like Ruin Guards or you have like 3 Maku Genkis in like the last Abyss, that was his really strong suit. So for the Perpetual Array, the new boss in Floor 12, and the single Maku Genki, Zhao has a hard time because he can only do so much damage and you have to basically serve enough energy for him to get his burst back. So Zhao without his burst is kind of like a mediocre character. The whole point of this character is for him to activate his burst and just to push up and down with all the enemies around. And that's what I'll say about Zhao. So if you're missing a DPS, a main DPS, and you're struggling on Abyss, I recommend you go for him. But again, Genshin Impact should be a game that you enjoy playing. So whatever character that you like or you currently feel that you should get, I don't recommend you take other people's opinions. Because if you end up hitting the character for some whatever reason, that should not be the case, and I would like everyone else to realize that this game is, the content is not hard to complete. It's more about what characters you want to use and what brings you the most joy in this game. So I love Child, but a lot of people don't like Child because of his downtime. I think it's great that he has a downtime feature because it allows you to create, you know, more time for your other characters that are in your team of 4. But other people may say, well, that's annoying because I want to use him all the time. And, you know, I can see how that would be. But again, like, I recommend you guys do what you want to do, and I'm here to say that Shenhe is not abyss friendly in this current abyss, but again, anything can change. MiHoYo has a really good way of promoting characters for certain abysses and making characters terrible in certain abysses. So, yeah, again, pull at your own risk. Make sure that you kind of like consider all these things when you're pulling for a character and how viable he is. Don't go get the character just because, you know, you think that they will bring you a, I guess, a new way of clearing content faster. Don't ever do that. Make sure you want to invest in a character that you enjoy playing. So, I'll let you guys enjoy the rest of this gameplay. This video is kind of long, but this is my first run in Abyss, and I think I failed a few times in Chamber 11. And by the way, if you guys want Chamber 12 and see how I do it, I guess full star Chamber or 412, feel free to leave a comment, and I will drop that video when I can. Take care.
你见为师圣的恩典创生天一声冰身无力的家伙起舞吧
真君，扭转，
失礼了，逃得掉吗？嘿，人，鹰吹雪。
天动万象，此即诞生。
不用悲鸣吧。这里，无能。这里，战报吧，风，回应我吧。
一决胜负，你造妖皇，欠朕伟业吧。固若金，天理长驱。
稍纵即逝，大意了！切，寒冰变神，日缺，仙法开匣，月神力流，双灭，失礼了。
一决胜负，无聊，就此消失。这里，无能。无能。风之神，请指引我们，
。
神速，
天动万象，
见证伟业吧。
无用，
风，回应我吧。
魔舞，这里，无能，这里，这里，
一决胜负，
固若金汤。
战报告，明谷于此险胜，
无用，
一决胜负。
真君，
一律奉行，听令。
失礼了，哼，嘿，哈。
忍着点，这可是很痛的。灵骨神速，
魂出，
起舞吧。生生不绝，起！哎，
失礼了，拿下！
久违的对手，御剑，仙法开匣，
起舞吧！风君真行。
之神，请指引我们。
散，
悲鸣吧。
这里，无能，
无用。
这里，
创生之宝，
固若金。
一决胜负，此局待生。
无聊。
此乃天道，
无聊。
风，回应我吧。
散。 天真赤揍，
雪纷飞，哼，无礼的家伙，
破绽稍纵即逝。
君真行，
失礼了。神力流，双灭。听诏，宣此告密，扭转不。起舞吧。
父君真行，寒冰变神。
嘿，耶呀，看。耶，失礼了。雪纷飞，真名杜恶真。
听令，
阴吹雪，起舞吧。
一律奉行。
生生不绝，扭转不
雪纷飞。
神力流，双灭。
为师，
请妖挪舞，
无能。
这里，这里，不用，不用，这里。
战报。
固若金，
鸣鼓，于此响。
无聊，
风，回应我吧。
震天撼地，天理长驱。
寒冰变神，一声冰身。
御剑，仙法开匣。
电气化神，
雪纷飞。
真行，
失礼了。
一律奉行，
起舞吧。神力流，双灭。听诏，宣此告密。
父君真行。
我 听到
小阳皇
大师身
后夜吧。
固若金的悲鸣吧。不用
凋零
无能
这里无能
乱招不够了
这里
只此一怒生一筹
天动万象
战报吧
此局待胜
风之神请指引我们
散
无聊
忍着点这可是很痛的
听令
哎怎么会
寒冰变神
更快一点居然
失礼了阴吹雪听令真赤纵
逃得掉吗
我听到
阳皇
在不用
人
见证伟业吧
老百姓
散
就消失
听你在哪
这里
无聊
无用
无能
这里
不用无聊
不够手下
天理长驱拒收并行
以剑为誓
一举
收
一剑止水
奉行前
呀呀呀要更快一点吗哎
久违的对手雪纷飞魂出我听到你
再多个对手也是
王让我听
于
此
行
你在哪
悲鸣吧
无能
无能 无聊。
这里，
无能。
退散。
等下。
这里，
丢
无能。
等下。
天动万象，俱收并蓄。
风，回应我吧！
一决胜负。
无聊。
归于减弱伟业吧。
就消失。无能。
这里。
你胜一筹。
要更快一点吗？你
逃得掉吗？
起舞，快，哈，耶，哈，耶，
耶，失礼了，看，天真赤纵。
生生不绝，即日间仙法开匣。
起舞吧，碧血诛除，听令。
拿下了
一剑止水，
前。
生生不绝，扭转不息。哈！
切！冰鬼神速！
失礼了，魂出！一律奉行。
听诏，宣此告命。
听令，起呀呀哈！
逃得掉吗？
之人必将得到成功。
让我听听，
一决胜负。明谷，于此险胜。
悲鸣吧，
这里
无能。
不用无聊。
接着一刀，
无能。
你胜一筹。
这里
无处可逃。
此乃天道。俱收并蓄，
以剑为誓，
一决胜。
无聊，
退散。你造妖皇，
幽灵
如花，如水而散。
固若金汤，
绽放吧。
无聊，
散。见证伟业吧。
风之神，请指引我。
散。死神。归于风雪，
失礼了。
一剑止水，哈！冰鬼神速，
去。
铁三飞，父君真行，
怎么会？
哼！天真赤纵，
生生不绝。
失礼了，看，
日间仙法开匣，要更快。
逃得掉吗？
神力流双雪纷飞，
无力的家伙，
夫君真行。
嘿，失礼了，
一律奉行。
起舞吧。该决断了。
不敬之人
必
将接受惩罚。
就消失。这里。不用。
抓住你
这方法，此即诞生之道。
以剑为师，
不接受。
这招还没结束，接住一刀，这招对付你。
天动万象。
上一招。
紧腰魔舞。
这里。
无能。无能。
我听到你
想找我试试刀法，
让我听听。
见证伟业吧。
你在哪儿？
一直上
刀下。
给你吧。
这里
还没结束。太好了，
这是
凋零。
恩赐。
无聊。
这里
上一招
无处可逃，
天理长驱，
创生之法，
此即
大风回应我吧。
散。
冰鬼神速，
失礼了。
一剑止水，
流转不息，
电气化神。寒冰变神，电气化神，
不赖嘛。
我听到你，
让我试试刀法。
固若金刚，
见证伟业吧。
不用。
太好了，
就消失。
这里
无能。
这是你的恩赐。
上一招
无能。
有一招凋零，
无处可逃。
天动万象，
你造阳华。 一律奉行，电气化神。
雪纷飞，起舞吧，
父君真行。
冰吹雪，听召宣此高，
一剑止水。
失礼了。
流转不息，呸！久违的对手，耶耶！起舞吧，呸！耶呸！
先，
失礼了，呸！
寒冰变身，
切！破绽稍纵即逝，冰鬼神速，冰鬼神速，
起舞吧，
生生不绝，
真名渡恶真君，
雪纷飞，
拿下了。